As I look back at this story and I think back on this story, and I over the years I've heard many people preach this text, and they've preached it, and one of the things that's very important when you share a text with somebody, a minister to somebody, is that sometimes it's the finer points and the finer details of the text that matter the most. And so over the years, as I've grown up in church, they've jumped down, they'll read that Elijah prophesied about that there would be no rain.
Well.
And then after they talk about him prophesying that there would be no rain, and then they would talk about, they would say that God told him to go to Cherith and that ravens were going to feed him there. And then they immediately jump to the fact that the brook dried up.
Yeah.
Come on.
Uh-huh. And that's cool. And there is a message in the fact that the brook dried up. Because there are times in our life where we get comfortable in a place that was only meant to be temporary. Oh, I wish I had a talk back church. There are times in our life when we get comfortable with people around us that were only meant to be temporary. There are times when we get comfortable with folk feeding us and taking care of us that was only meant to be temporary. At some point, you're going to have to make your move beyond the place of the temporary to the place of where God does something else in your life a different way.
Come on.
I come to tell you, yes, God is getting ready to do some things in a different way in your life. But you got to stop and pay attention to this moment right here.
Come on.
You can't bypass the brook. Look,
yeah. Uh-huh.
Tell somebody, say, I can't bypass the brook.
I can't bypass the brook.
Can't bypass the brook.
Come on.
There's so much meat in that text that people tend to overlook, First Lady. It blows my mind. And today I was thinking about, I was in a service on Friday night, and this man began to preach, and he said, the ravens are coming. And he had the people just start saying, flap, flap, flap. I hear the sound of the ravens coming. Flap, flap, flap. I hear the sound of the ravens coming. Flap, flap, flap. I hear the sound of the ravens coming. So as I was sitting there a few minutes ago when Bishop was talking and said, your stuff is coming, get ready to receive your stuff. That's why I kept hollering, Bishop, you're meddling, because I felt in my spirit this morning God telling me to tell somebody it can happen. See, and Bishop turned around and declared, I believe that there will be a word from the Lord released in here that's going to change somebody's life. Well, this is the word that's going to change somebody's life this morning. Somebody holler, it can happen.
It can happen.
Now, we know the story, or you may not know the story. Elijah had had the battle and the showdown with the prophets of Baal and all that stuff. There's a whole lot of stuff that went on. Elijah was a great man. And there came a point where Elijah, now Ahab was the king, and he messed around and hooked up with somebody he shouldn't have hooked up with. Ahab hooked up with Jezebel. And because he hooked up with Jezebel, Jezebel had this spirit about her that she wanted to take over and take control. And she adjusted Ahab's way of thinking and had Ahab trying to expand territory in ways that he wasn't supposed to do it. Well, Elijah had to stand all by himself up against all the prophets of Baal and the prophets of the grove. We always talk about the 400 prophets of Baal, but the Bible also talks about that there were 450 prophets of the grove. So he actually stood against 850 prophets at least to stand and declare that God is God. Why are you talking about that, overseer? Why are you talking about that, elder? Because I need you to understand there has to be a stand in your life for the things of God.
Yes,
that was a place for a good amen. There has to be a place where you take a stand for the things of God.
Amen.
We've gotten to a place where the church has become too watered down. I was sitting, oh God, I'm going to get in trouble right here. I was sitting one Saturday and I was watching, I saw they got a show out called The Preachers of Atlanta.
Uh-huh.
And it seems like with every city that this particular series goes to, they had preachers of LA first, then they had preachers of Detroit, and now they got preachers of Atlanta, and they've got preachers in Atlanta going down handing out condoms and cigarettes on the streets. Pastors. And I understand to some degree what she was trying to say in the sense that if people are going to do it, protect us, but why are you handing out cigarettes too? That's what. Then they're talking about one particular one of the people on the show. His father is a gay pastor in Atlanta. He stood up in front of his church on a Wednesday night and told the church, "This is who I am." And so, on the show, they're talking about the fact that it's in some ways they're saying it's acceptable. And we got to start just accepting any old thing in the church. Now listen, I'm the last one to beat up on anybody about that lifestyle. I'm the last one to stand and beat up. Because I'm going to tell you something. One thing about it, right or wrong, from the pulpit to the back door, me included. That lifestyle is unacceptable before the Lord. So I can't live it and we can't live it. It's got to be holiness or hell. I don't care whether it's a fight, a struggle, or whatever. If you're fighting, you better fight. I can't hear nobody. Now see, let me hit the church for a minute. Because one of the problems the church has is we condemn folk who are in the fight. Instead of trying to help them get free. So what we do is we beat them up, we knock them down, we hit them, and talk about how bad they are. But what about some of the stuff you do? Let's talk about if the lights were to come on at a sudden moment with you. You worry about who they're sleeping with, well, what about who you're sleeping with? Doesn't make your sin any better than their sin because you sleeping with a woman and he's sleeping with a man. Can I really preach up in here today? You're better than. Oh Lord. Now this is a little scary for me because this is going on camera, but I'm going to go ahead and say it anyway. I remember when I was in my struggle and I was in my fight dealing with that very same lifestyle. And I remember that somebody, matter of fact, I'm going to go ahead and call it and just be very real. We just won't put this one on YouTube. This will be in-house message. I remember when my wife at the time when I was dealing with my struggle, yes, I was dealing with it while I was married. And I didn't get married to cover it up. It's about time somebody start talking real in the house of God. I didn't get married to cover it up. But let me tell you, my wife acted like all the stuff that I was doing and I was struggling with, she acted like I was the worst one in the world. Beat me up, talk bad to me, abuse me emotionally in my spirit because of my struggle. But she was a verbal abuser. And I told her, I said, what you don't realize is the same way that HIV can take somebody else out, being verbally abused can kill somebody. Oh, I wish I had a church in here. Being verbally abused can kill somebody. It can do the exact same things that HIV can do. HIV wears your immune system down. When you've been abused and when you've been hurt, it wears your immune system down. You get sick because you don't have any people that know what I'm talking about. And the bad thing about verbal abuse is an emotional abuse is that you don't get to see the scars. Some of y'all might not want to come back to Kingdom after this. I don't want to. But I was made to seem like I was horrible. I was just so horrible. horrible and such a bad person. And what made it so bad was she made it like hers was better than mine. And I kept trying to tell her, you're no better than me. We both need the grace of God. So saints of God, when you run into a homosexual, run into them and love them back to life. Yeah. I'm not telling you to condone the sin, but I'm telling you to love them back to life. Be a place of restoration for them.
That's right.
Oh God, help me here. The Bible said that he has made us ministers of reconciliation. Come back to God when you hating on them and hurting them and abusing them. And I'm going to just touch this and I'm going to move off the subject, but it bothers me in my spirit that it seems like homosexuality is the only sin folk know how to preach about. But you want to talk about them. You cheating on, oh Lord. Preacher, you cheating on your wife with the woman sitting on the front row next to your wife. But you want to talk about them. You get on the telephone. And you get to talking about other folks. Gossiping spirit, tale-bearing spirit. It's in the church. But you act like you so much better than everybody else.
Come on, Elder. You better preach.
Immature.
Yes, Lord.
Acting like you so wonderful. I heard an old song say, Mr. Big Stuff.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Who in the world do you think you are? If it wasn't for the God, I'm shot right there. Oh, I wish I had a church right there. If it wasn't for the grace of somebody, you ought to just take a moment and praise him for the grace of God. Oh, I feel something right there. I can just stay right there. Where would I be if it wasn't for them?
Somebody ought to worship before his grace.
Somebody ought to worship before his grace. I know I'm trying to preach this message, but you ought to worship before his grace. Where would you be without his grace? Where would you be without his mercy? Where would you be? Where would you be? Where would you be? Where would I be? Where would any of us in this room be if it was not for the grace of God? When we start talking about amazing grace. When you start really thinking about just what that grace brought you out of. Oh, I wish I had a church right there. When you start thinking about what that grace brought you out of. Then you really realize just how amazing the grace is. Trying to move, but I feel that right there.
Let him use you.
Amazing grace.
Thank you, Jesus.
Woo!
Yes, sir.
Would have lost it all.
Yes, sir.
If it wasn't for grace.
Yeah.
I would have gone crazy.
Yeah.
anybody else in here would have gone crazy if it wasn't for grace. Anybody used to be on some drugs and you could have smoked something that would have messed you up for the rest of your life, but God kept your mind because of grace. I know somebody right now in Jacksonville, Florida, Mama Tita, that the boy smoked, he went and smoked some weed. It was a drummer for a church, went and smoked some weed, and the weed was laced, and the weed caused him, and with the stuff that was in it, caused him to go kill his mother. Didn't just kill her, but chopped her body up with a kitchen knife. I know it for real. I was there. I ain't telling you what I heard. I was there. That weed was laced and it took him out of his mind. Some of y'all smoked some stuff and snorted some stuff and shot up some stuff, and yet you are still alive today to tell about it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, if we have a hammer, this will be a spot where we just break off and just dance. Because if, oh, Bishop, don't do that because I feel that it could have been me. Somebody just holler, it could have been me.
Thank you.
I feel grace releasing somebody from struggle. Deuteronomy chapter 30. He says, I set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. And then it goes on to say, choose life. In the Holy Ghost right now, I see an open door for somebody. I see an open door in this atmosphere. I see an open door in the atmosphere. The Lord said, I open the door for you to walk through. He said, I'm bringing freedom. I'm bringing deliverance. Christ is here. You don't have to struggle emotionally anymore. Grace is here.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Grace is bringing somebody out of your brokenness right now. Grace is here. Pray. That's it. Come on. I don't know who you are, but you're in this room and you need the grace of God. And the enemy lied to you and told you that God dropped you. God has not dropped you. God has not let you down. God said, I still got you. I'm still holding you. He said, the reason why you're still here, I've been sustaining you all along. Grace is here. I'm trying to move, but I feel it. There's grace in here for somebody. There's an influx of God's grace and an outpouring of God's grace. You ought to receive it right now. This is not a normal Sunday. I feel it. See what happens when the ministers and elders start consecrating? When leaders start going before God. And I'm going to tell you what I've been feeling in my spirit. The leaders have not just been crying out, God, touch the church. The leaders have been saying, God, change me. Leaders, am I talking right? Is that what you've been crying? Before you ever prayed for anybody else, you were saying, God, please, fix me. Fixing somebody right now. David would declare, create in me a clean heart. Renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence. And whatever you do, God, don't take your Holy Spirit away from me. Because I really don't even know what to do. I got a whole message I can preach. But something's happening in here.
Yeah.
sheriff. There is no option. The raven. Now, I'll tell y'all about the raven another time, but I'll tell you this much. The raven is one of the smartest birds in the animal kingdom. Matter of fact, in some of the tests, he outdid the monkey.
Oh.
Ravens have been known to figure stuff out.
The raven.
And it might look intimidating when the raven comes, but he's got something in his mouth.
Yes, Jesus. Woo! Yes, my God.
Might be what looks like an ugly bird. But big blessings are coming in an ugly package. Lord, I don't care what package you got to send it to me in. The Bible declares that the ravens came not just one time a day, but the ravens came twice a day to feed the man of God. Came with bread and came with meat. Now, what makes me celebrate is that ravens eat a whole bunch of stuff. Ravens are garbage eaters. Ravens eat nuts and fruits, and then they also eat what they call carrion, which is stuff that's dead. But God was so amazing is that he changed the appetite of a dirty bird in order to bless Elijah. God's getting ready to change some appetites of some folk around you just so they can come and be a blessing to you. God's getting ready to cause it to open up in your life. Get ready.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Normally, it would eat dirty stuff. Normally, it would eat dead stuff. But God changed the appetite of the bird to bring meat in his beak that was suitable for Elijah to eat. Dead stuff would have killed him because they didn't have refrigeration at that time. But something fresh was coming to the man of God. And I prophesy in this atmosphere. Oh, y'all, excuse me. But I prophesy in this atmosphere that something alive, something fresh is coming to your life. Get ready. Something fresh is coming to your life. Something fresh is coming to your life. You're not just getting one portion. Not just one portion. But I declare in the name of the Lord, he came twice a day. A double portion of the blessing is coming. Say yeah.
Yes, Lord. Oh.
You ought to tell somebody, say, oh neighbor,
oh, neighbor.
A double portion just hit my life.
Because
I'm in the right place at the right time. I know I'm being cut off, but a double portion just came to my life. God sent in some ravens to fix my life. God sent in some ravens to take care of me. Declared by the prophet, and nobody else around was able to eat, and nobody else was really able to drink. But one thing that blesses me is that in the midst of a famine, God has promised, I will take care of you. I will. When everybody else is drying up, in the time of famine, is God going to give you enough? But he's going to give you a double portion. You're going to lay down at night, and by the time you wake up in the morning, you're going to feel something different happening in your life. You're going to go to work in kids going to grab it, and it's going to happen. Last time we started talking like this, somebody got a miracle the very next day. Then the next Sunday, the Lord has declared again, somebody's going to get a miracle the very next day. I got a message in my inbox that somebody who previously had a bill with KUB that was thousands of dollars, they sent me the picture of the bill that they got for that month, and the bill had a negative balance. They had a credit on their account. The last time we started talking like this. Now I just feel like if God opened up this wind and starts prophesying it again, somebody better grab it and declare it's my time for a double portion. Yes? Watch what's about to hit your life. Double portion. Folk that didn't want to bless you, gonna have to let it go and bless you. Yeah! Folk that didn't want to release what's yours, they're going to have to release what's yours. Yes! Today is your day. Sister Cindy, I don't know what I'm talking about, but I hear the Holy Ghost. He said, tell Cindy that whoever held it up, they can't hold it up anymore. He told me to tell you that today is your day of a double portion. Watch me do it. Here, and I feel a double portion about to hit my life. I don't know about y'all, and if y'all want to sit there and not get yours, I don't preach it, but I'm going to get mine. Not only am I going to get mine, but I'm going to declare in the name of the Lord, my bishop, my first lady, I'm going to get their double portion.
Yeah.
place. And there the Lord has commanded. And isn't it amazing that the birds knew where to find him? When God has commanded the blessing and you are seated in the right place at the right time, the birds gotta find you. When God has commanded the blessing of the Lord to be upon your life, when you're in the right place at the right time, you ought to expect, if God said it, he will. Such three people say it will come to pass. Hey God.
Yeah.
You've held your integrity. You've held your character. You had days when you wanted to give up, but God said you can't.
Yeah, yeah.
And because you serve the man of God,
yes,
it's impossible for him not to bless you.
Yes. Oh,
specifically bless you.
Yes.
$555 trips from the Ravens.
Yes.